I know it's a little bit earlier than normal, but I wanted to just kind of show you a little bit more about my daily goings on. And I thought it'd be really cool to have dinner with you guys. That's cool. Awesome. So we're gonna step into the kitchen here. I'll show you guys what we're having for dinner tonight. Tell me what you guys think. So Beyond Burger meat patties. These are really good. I know. Vegetarian. Ugh. But it's not like it's I think it's the middle lighting. That light up there is terrible. Right about there, maybe? Yeah, that's my kitchen. No tables, I just sit at the desk over here.
There's the living room, TV, computer monitor, piano. Hoorah.
Thing is massive. I'm gonna shake this. So to give you guys a sense of scale, that's the size of my chair. I thought about using my laptop and the webcam in the other room, but I was like, you know what? It'd probably be a lot easier just using my phone. And my phone's an iPhone 7, so it's pretty good. This is a pleather. It's like a plastic. It's really comfortable though. Anyway, One Punch Man, Toy Story. All right. Look at this mess. It's fine. No worries. Moved here about a month ago. Actually, a month and a half ago. It's pretty nice. It's 700 square feet plus. Anyway, we're gonna go back into the kitchen because I wanna make dinner because I'm getting hungry. So I got myself the George Foreman here. I don't know why there's a tape measure on the counter, but there's a tape measure there. Has nothing to do with cooking. Okay. So if I give you guys angle here. Have no idea what this looks like. Ta-da! So we're just gonna do one. Oh shoot, you know what? I actually need to get the other part started because this is gonna take like 5 minutes. So, hope I'm not making you guys busy. That would be unfortunate. Here's the other part. Now that I think about it, we could do this. Not too realistic. That actually might be really good. Or Raleigh's famous fries. Those are exceptional. I forgot I had those cheese sticks. Oh. To do what to do. A little bit of both? Yes. Can I? Dare I? We're gonna do it. Yep. There's really not a good place for this, so let's do this.
First, let's go ahead and preheat this oven right here. I like 375. Everything cooks pretty well. If it doesn't, just leave it in there a little bit longer. Hope it's not too loud for the mic. I'm gonna move back. Somebody said, why don't you make this from scratch? Shame on you. Could you imagine making french fries from scratch for one person? You got a roommate? Hell yeah. I'd do that right now. You guys still see okay? These are some ridiculously good french fries. They're even better if you actually go to a rally and get them, but still. They're like Arby's, sort of. Because we dare, we're doing the mozzarella stick. Shazbot. Guys, if my volume is low, let me know. I've never streamed with a phone before. No idea what the quality is like. What the volume levels or any of that good stuff. Alright, so there we go. French fries, mozzarella sticks. It's pretty good. So later we're going to be adding a bunch of vegetables. So I don't want you guys thinking that, yeah, let's carb up. That's not too much. I don't think that's too much if you exercise. And I'm going to the gym tomorrow. I go every other day. So usually I'll do like 4 of the sticks if I'm just not trying to get a bunch of carbs, but yeah, those french fries are big and tasty and fantastic, and we're gonna put it over here with a good old slab of quote-unquote beef, one of these right there. Once that gets going, we got a few different sauces here, but I like this horseradish sauce on that. Is really, really good. It's like Arby's horseradish sauce. And I'm gonna take that out now. Got some tomatoes, spinach, none of the iceberg lettuce junk. Iceberg is garbage. What else we got? Throw some Pepsi in there. So we got about a minute and a half to get that oven preheated. Gonna throw it in there, probably be 20.
20 minutes? I know by the smell. I hope this cooks okay, because you've got two different kinds of food on there. It's always kind of weird if like one cooks more than the other or something, but should be fine. And that's just gonna go on a plate. The beef patties are just gonna go on a plate. I don't have any buns, which is fine because it kind of takes away the flavor when you put it on a bun. And I really want to put the salad in there. The salad's gonna have a ton of flavor. So you're gonna have the meat flavor from this, and then the cheese from this, and some spices. It's not spicy, but it's flavorful right there. I think it's gonna turn out pretty good. All right, we're ready. Let's see if I can do this. Timer? Nah, we don't use timers. What a catastrophe in that kitchen. Dining room, actually. What else? The real fun's gonna be when I get to chop up the tomatoes and get that salad started, because I like salad. I know I'm a guy and I like salad. I love the neighbors. So I guess I'm just gonna chill here for a minute, yeah. Like I said, when you're cooking in an oven, you really wanna use your nose more than anything else. It's not a bad idea to have a ballpark of how long it should take. The thinner the thing you're cooking, the faster it's gonna cook. So if you're doing a pot pie, like a Marie Callender's, and you're doing in the oven, it's gonna be at least 45 minutes. Those are a lot of fun, by the way, because put a little bit of foil on top, and then like 40 minutes in, you start to smell it, and you're just like, oh, that's good. And then as time goes by, the smells just get better and better, and you're just like, oh, this is getting crispy. And you start smelling like the beef or the turkey or whatever's in there mixed with those vegetables. Really, really good. And then you hear a little bit of bubbling. Like, whoa. 45 minutes to an hour in, you're done. And then, you know, it's a pot pie, so it's obviously ridiculously good. My favorite are the Marie Callender's. I actually have one. I like to buy them and then like cook them on the weekends, because I'll be sitting there and I'll be like, you know what? It's 5 o'clock. I'm gonna eat dinner at 6. Why don't I go and throw one of those in there? Plus it saves you a ton of money. They're only like $2.50. So these are really, really good. They're basically a meal. You can obviously throw other stuff with it, but I used to do that and then like some ice cream or something. Nom 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 nom. What's that like? Oh, just in case, we do have seasoned curly fries from Arby's. Also got lots of fish. Shrimp scampi, battered cod. Yes, we have that down right now. I'm really trying to go more with fish and shrimp, especially when it's on sale. It's fantastic to get. It's nice to have something besides beef. Beef, beef, beef. This Beyond Burger, it actually tastes like meatloaf. When I first tried it, I tasted it and I was like, does it need any kind of seasoning whatsoever? Then that's when I had the idea about the horseradish, because horseradish with a meatloaf flavor. It's really, really good. If you guys ever have meatloaf, I highly recommend it. And it's the same price. It's like $2.50 for a bottle of horseradish sauce. You don't have to go to Arby's. You don't have to get wait in line. Get the little packets. Get you a bottle. Put it on sandwiches. It's a great alternative to mustard. And it works with cheeses too. So if you're doing like a turkey sandwich with turkey and Swiss, just on the other piece of bread, throw that horseradish on there instead of mustard. Because, you know, after a few years, mustard gets kind of boring. You can also do honey Dijon mustard, which is cool. But just go with horseradish sauce for like a week. See if you like it. It's got a tang to it. There's no sweetness, really. What else? For a drink that we're having with dinner, it would probably be fruit punch or wild cherry Pepsi. We got both those on hand. We got some other stuff too, but those are the ones we got. You don't want it to overpower what you're eating. So I'm thinking the fruit punch. Pepsi goes really, really well with like things with onions in it. Has such a crisp, bold flavor. It goes and really well with onions. It can be regular onions, red onions. But if you put it with like cucumber and what else would taste really bad? Olives would be really good. Like black olives. I should come up with some more dinner ideas. I like this. I usually do something. Like tomorrow I could do pasta and shrimp scampi. Show you guys the pantry real quick. Alright, so there's no light in here, so I hope you guys can see what we got. Frosted mini wheats. All this is gonna be whole grain because we don't do enriched flour. That's terrible. Well, I guess that's not true. Some of this is. But we try and really aim for stuff like this right here. 100% organic whole wheat. We've got penne, we've got rotini, and where is it? Oh, eeks. Almost spilled it up. Whole grain spaghetti. One of my favorites. What is that doing there? Ramen? What the heck? Sneaky little pecker. Then soups. Soups are great because, again, it's cheap. It's like $2.50 for a can. We got some garlic toast in the freezer. Throw it with that clam chowder there on the right. Even our wheat thins. Even the wheat thins are whole grain. And we need this bulk up. Hoorah. You guys want to see my secret stash of goodies? Nom 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 nom. Donuts and cakes and cookies. These are really, really good. They're very, very sweet. Like, almost too sweet. And pumpkin spice rolls. If you want calories, this is the way to go. If you want healthy calories, that is much better. Good old banana. Super cheap, super good for you. They go really well with a lunch. You don't have to package it. You don't have to do anything with it. Just throw it in the lunchbox.
turn on the TV, but I don't think that Twitch would like me having you guys listen to copyrighted material. I'm watching Blackish, if that helps. I can show you guys real quick. We can listen to music though, right? Pretty sure. I turn on some tunes. Show you guys what I got on my playlist right here. If there's anything that pops out that you guys want to listen to, let me know. I'm thinking. No, how about this one? And again, I'm not sure how it sounds to you guys. I really need to look into that. You guys probably don't want to see me dance. It's too loud, let me know. DJ's taking me much. You guys, since you're hearing the music, I'm gonna go check on the French fries.
You hear that sizzle? Mozzarella sticks and Raleigh's French fries.
Thank you. These are really, really good. It's almost time to go ahead and throw on these patties right here. Boom. Beyond burger. No beef. I know, Lady Gaga, shoot me. You know what? I don't care. It's a good song. The advantages of being ambidextrous. I can use both hands. That's what ambidextrous means. Yeah. Oh, that smells awful. It smells like dog food. It doesn't taste like dog food. Maybe it is dog food. They're like, bet you we can sell this stuff and say it's plant-based. Think they'll buy it? Yeah. All right, we got that going now. George Foreman power. They had a bunch of these for sale for $1.99, so I bought two of them. They're usually $5, $4.99. Like I said, they're really, really good, and it tastes like meatloaf. I'm not feeling this. It's almost over, but still. What else we got? Something a little less gay. Ooh, how about this one? I wish I had my stereo. Yeah.
bread is starting to sizzle.
Commercials. You guys might be able to hear that sizzle now. We'll go take a look.
Excuse the mess. I'm not going to even show it to you guys. Looks terrible. The dining room is not even a dining room. At first, it really does smell like dog food. Then when you start getting closer, it starts to smell good.
Oh, that looks so gross.
Remember, do not overcook it. It's better to... Well, the scientists would say, and the safety people would say, overcook it. But it's... Yeah, just don't. It's bad. Because it's so processed, it's probably not going to be a bad idea to just go ahead and take it off. I don't think we're going to get sick from it.
How about those french fries, though? Wait, could you guys hear it?
Yes, right?
In case you guys are wondering, that's why I've got this paper in there. Earlier, it looked pretty weird. I'm a little worried those french fries haven't cooked right. We can take it out though.
See about it.
So the mozzarella is going to go really, really well with that beef, quote unquote. Let's see. These actually look... Yeah, they're a little undone. But those sticks are definitely done. A couple more minutes. If the sticks overcooked, that's fine. It's just bread and sticks. But you want the fries to be crunchy on the outside, fluffy on the inside. And they're getting there. They're not cold. But, yeah. They're not good either. We need to take that beef patty off. The George Foremans, they're really, really good. I wouldn't recommend them for fish. That's the only thing. Nom, 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 nom. Fish is much better served by like searing it in a pan. Just a little bit of oil. Usually they'll have some kind of batter or some kind of it's been soaked in something, so it usually just cook on its own. But if you want to add a little bit of butter for a little bit sweeter flavor, that'd be fine. Never, ever, 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 ever take a piece of meat off a grill and then start cutting into it. You ruin it. So take it out, put it aside, you let it rest. All the juices and stuff, this doesn't really have juices, but the juices get absorbed into the meat as it rests. If you cut right into it, it all comes out. It's no good.
What a mess. It's okay. I learned that the hard way. After a couple of times, I was like, you know what? This chicken is just too dry, and I can't believe this George Foreman is supposed to be this wonderful thing, and then it keeps coming out, and it tastes like I'm eating newspaper. And then, I don't know, I was reading an article or something, and no, I was watching a TV show, and it was like, you know, these fancy people, and they're saying, well, what's the number one thing not to do when you're cooking a steak, or a piece of chicken, or a piece of fish? They said, don't eat, start eating it right when you take it off. Leave it for a few minutes. Let it soak up all the seasoning that you put in there. Let it rest. Because the seasoning, it drops down when you're cooking. And then it kind of bubbles and stuff, and it's kind of moving around. When you have it rest, the seasoning just stays there. If you cut right into it, it's still hot and it's still moving around a bunch, and it just comes right out, and it doesn't stay sealed in the food that you're cooking. Like, if you ever sat down to a turkey dinner, and then as soon as you take it out of the oven, everybody starts eating. No. 5-10 minutes, everybody sits down, says their graces, and then you're like, all right, let's do it. Tastes so much better. Worst comes to worst, you use gravy, right? I mentioned it earlier, but when you're cooking something in the oven, always use your nose. Always go by the smell. So when that was cooking, I could smell the cheese sticks. It was overpowering the French fries. So I was thinking, you know, it's got more stuff there. So it's probably why I'm smelling it more. And it's because it cooked more. Here in a minute, the French fries will be done. And it'll be really, really good. Have cheesy, meaty, I don't know what the right word is. It's not spicy, but it's not bland either. Those French fries are Raley's French fries, and they're really good. They're seasoned. And, I mean, you can't go wrong with putting some ketchup on it. That's no problem at all. The meat, we're going to do horseradish sauce on top of it. Please don't put ketchup on it. If you put ketchup on it, shame on you. Don't do that. Go with something different. That's why I stopped going to fast food places. You've got ketchup and mustard. Or ketchup. Or fancy ketchup. Oh. No. Gotta think outside the box.
You said creativity, huh?
This is what we've got in this fridge here. That's blueberries. Got mayo, pickles, ketchup. Gotta use it. This is also really, really good. I'm not gonna use it on the beef, but it's really, really good. I've been using it a lot with shrimp. Like battered shrimp, it's really, really good. It's hard to describe what it's like. Tastes like mango. It's spicy. It's not a long lasting spice. I don't like it when the spice lasts for like 30 minutes. It just sits there like Tabasco sauce. The vinegar just sits there and got a couple of salad dressings. But this, wait, last thing. I'll show you the other thing. Last. It's not bad. I'm gonna try something different. There's like 50 different kinds of barbecue sauce, and 45 of them taste the exact same. But this is what I like right here. Horseradish sauce. So, as it says in the name, it's great on sandwiches. This right here. All natural, no antibiotics. No antibiotics. Turkey, turkey. So, if you're thinking, I'm just so tired of mustard, it's nothing but mustard every single time I make a sandwich. Well, horseradish sauce. Tastes really good. Again, it's spicy, but the spice doesn't last that long. When you put it on a sandwich, if you're like, I don't like spicy, but I don't like bland. Well, that spice goes away pretty quickly because you got the bread. You can put cheese on it. It goes well with cheese. Like right there, I do turkey and I think I've got Havarti. I don't want to lie. So, here we go. Yeah, Havarti. Ta-da! Havarti doesn't really have any flavor, so that's... I don't know. Got tired of turkey and Swiss. Munster? The Addams Family? I don't know. That one's not bad either. But you can put that horseradish sauce on anything. On any kind of sandwich, whatever you're making. Roast beef, chicken, turkey, ham. The worst combination is with ham. The best combination is probably turkey or roast beef. If you're trying to kick roast beef, I recommend turkey. Because you can do turkey in mesquite, I think applewood, maybe that's ham again, oven roasted. And then you can mix it up with so many different cheeses. I'm even thinking about dropping mayonnaise for something different. I don't want to get too far away from this, these French fries and stuff. You overcook it, all the cheese spills out, and then you just got a big thing of cheese. So it's going pretty good. You can see these smaller pieces are getting more cooked. Hope I don't cook my phone. The good news is, and the one thing I was worrying about, is if you overcook those cheese sticks there, the cheese starts spilling out. It goes... It makes a sound that's like that, but... You can't hear it. Smell right now. There's a really good smell from this. It's very beef-like. It's going really, really well with that cheese smell and the spices from the French fries. If anybody figures out an app to be able to transfer sense of smell across the internet, you'll be a millionaire. Billionaire. Trillionaire. Take over the world with that kind of money. What time is it? I gotta start up my PC because we're gonna do some games after dinner. It's a piano. It's a desk that's made to look like a piano. Nope, actual piano. It's a fake piano. Nope. Mm-mm. Off. Nope. Doesn't want to turn off. I think this is still blackish. Pretty sure. Yeah.
I'm still going by my nose. Once you smell that it's actually burnt, I mean, there's not much you can do. But right now, it's right at that crispy stage. And then just a little bit more, a little bit more, and then oops, burnt. So it's right there. Another good tip, when you're baking something, especially like French fries or fish, if you're not sure if it's done, go ahead and pull it out. The worst thing to do is overcook it. It's much easier. Oh, I should have shown you guys. Hold on. It's much easier to undercook. You can see when I take it out right now, it's still cooking. Don't believe me? Then you don't believe in science. So all the heat that was used to cook the food is still in the food because it's still hot, right? Was 375, that's now 375 or more, probably more. That heat is now dissipating out. I'm just leaving the food and going into my apartment. Woohoo! We're gonna leave it there, let it sit for a minute. I think I got it right. You guys wanna check it out? Let's see if I can do this. It's okay. Processed cheese. A processed cheese would make it be all stringy and stretchy and stuff. But that's real cheese. So it just, yeah. There's no thematics to it. I think it's time to plate this. Now comes the fun part. Here in a minute, we're gonna get the salad ready. And you guys don't know me, but I love tomatoes. Small tomatoes especially. Like little cherry ones, because it's like a grape, but the tomato. So we're not gonna let this sit too long, just for a minute. Go and see just how crispy these are. Come on, eat me. They're right there. Crunchy on the outside, fluffy on the inside. I'm kind of surprised that it actually turned out this well. Oh, it's much better than it was before. That stuff was nasty. Seconds. That was like 20, but whatever. Alright, so let's check this out. How did the beef turn out? After we let it rest, what do you guys think? Looks like beef, right? Smells like beef. Take a taste. It's not bad. It's not like a steak or anything. Like I said, it's like meatloaf. Alright, now comes the hard part. How am I going to cut some tomatoes with one hand? Is it possible? I have no idea. There we go. Always get the green stuff. The green stuff is better.
If you get iceberg lettuce, I don't want to be friends with you.
That's pretty harsh, but no. Iceberg lettuce has next to no nutrition. So here, got a nice tomato. Yep. Vine ripened. I believe you. Alright, this is an absolutely fantastic knife. It's a little dirty. Whatever. It's just cheese. I don't think I've got the box here, but it's a knife that was made in Germany. It's an absolutely fantastic knife. My stepmom bought it for me for her birthday, I think it was. And I wouldn't use any other knife. So here we go. Watch. If I can cut a tomato with one hand, that means this knife is a boss. Look at that. And it's a boss. See, and it's not squishing any of the pieces. That's about as good as I'm going to be able to do one-handed. Yep, starting to squish. And it's up to you guys whether you want to keep these big pieces like this. I typically do about half that. Makes it bite-sized. If I had both hands, it would be easier. Should we do both? We should. Unfortunately, I don't have any other vegetables. It would be really, really nice to have some cucumbers or... Well, I like cucumbers. I was going to say broccoli, but broccoli is actually kind of nasty. What else do I like? Peppers. Peppers I'm really big into. Red peppers, green peppers. I want to get this green piece out. And I'm just going to dice this up real fast. It's taking too long. Doesn't matter, it's all going to the same place, right? In my belly. And definitely use the conventional plating technique for this. Oh. It's already ready to eat. Grab some of this, more the merrier. Throw it on the side. Again, nothing fancy, just a pile of vegetables. You guys got any preference on what kind of salad dressing? I'm kind of leaning towards the Thousand Island, the white one. But thinking honey mustard would be too powerful. Definitely not the sesame seed ginger. A bad idea. Let's see what we got. So we got French. Classic olive oil and vinegar. You know, I think that's the one. Bread and butter pickle with it though. Nope. Too much. I'm just gonna put a little bit on there. Doo-doo.
like I said, we got water here, Pepsi, or fruit punch. Fruit punch.
Water would be too bland. Pepsi would be too much. Okay. Let me go ahead and log in real quick.
Oh man, the music's been going the entire time. Right, whatever. The fun part about all this, there's really no dishes. There's that. And there's that. That's it.